conversation concerning life and death.
I read in your books, Sade, in one of your immortal works, that the animating force of nature is destruction, and that our only instrument for measuring life is death.
Correct, Marat. But man has given a false importance to death. Every animal, plant, or man that dies adds to nature's compost heap, becomes the manure without which nothing could grow, nothing could be created. Death is simply part of the process. Every death, even the cruelest death, drowns in the total indifference of nature. Nature would watch unmoved if we destroyed the entire human race. I hate nature. This passionless spectator, this unbreakable iceberg face that can bear everything, this goads us to greater and greater acts. But though I hate this goddess, I see that the greatest acts in history have followed her laws. Nature teaches a man to fight for his own happiness, and if he must kill to gain that happens, why then the murder is natural. Haven't we always crushed down those weaker than ourselves? Haven't we torn at the throats of the powerful with continuous villainy and lust? Haven't we experimented in our laboratories before applying the final solution? Man is a destroyer. But if he kills and takes no pleasure in it, he's a machine. He should destroy with passion, like a man. Let me remind you of the execution of Damien after his unsuccessful attempt to assassinate Louis XV. Remember how Damien died? How gentle the guillotine is compared with his torture? It lasted 4 hours while the crowd goggled, and Casanova at another window felt under the skirts of the ladies watching. His chest, arms, thighs, and calves were slit open. Molten lead they poured into each slit, boiling oil they poured over him, burning wax, sulfur. They burnt off his hands. They tied ropes to his arms and to his legs, and harnessed him to 4 horses and yeed them up. They pulled at him for an hour, but they'd never done it before, and he wouldn't come apart until they sawed through his shoulders and his hips. So he lost the first arm, and then the second arm, and he watched what they did to him. And then he turned to us, and he shouted out so that everyone could understand. And when he lost the first leg, and then the second leg, he still lived. And in the end, he hung there, a bloody torso, with a nodding head, just groaning and staring at the crucifix which the father confessor held up to him. That was a festival with which today's festivals can't compete. Even our Inquisition has no meaning nowadays. Now it is all official. We condemn to death without emotion. And there's no singular, personal death to be had. Only an anonymous, cheapened death that we could dole out to entire nations on a mathematical basis. Until the time comes for all life to be extinguished.
You may sit as a judge on our tribunals. You may have fought with us last September when we dragged out of the jails the aristocrats who were plotting against us. But you still talk like a grand seigneur. And what you call the indifference of nature is your own lack of compassion.
Compassion, Marat, is the property of the privileged classes. When the giver bends to the beggar, he throbs with contempt. To protect his riches, he pretends to be moved. and his gift to the beggar is no more than a kick. No, no, Mara, no small emotions, please. Your feelings were never petty, for you, just as for me. Only the most extreme actions matter.
If I am extreme, I am not extreme in the same way as you. Against nature's silence, I use action. In the vast indifference, I invent a meaning. I don't watch unmoved. I intervene. And I say that this and this are wrong. And I work to alter them and to improve them because they're... The important thing is to pull yourself up by your own hair. To turn yourself inside out and see the whole world with fresh eyes.